This is the tutorial. We are going to take a look at this problem and solve it. In the process, we reiterate some of the learnings and some new ideas may also emerge. So take a minute to read through the question. You can pause the video. I'm going to bring in the specifics, the details at one place. So the fixed cost is 500,000, which is one time. The variable cost per unit is 600 per unit. The fixed costs are towards setting up the plant, which produces, okay, the capacity is given to you. Let me write it here. Capacity is 500 units per year. The variable cost includes raw material, contents is fine, and you have price, which is 1000 per piece. So the first question is, what is the minimum level of production for Anil to decide positively in favor of this business? What does it mean? It means the person should be able to say, okay, I'm taking this opportunity up. When will that happen? When you are in profit. So you want to know, when is it that you are going to be in profit? What is the minimum level of production? So we know that, of course, we have to figure out the break-even point. The quantity of break-even point is equal to fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. The fixed cost is given to be 5 lakhs and divide this by the contribution per unit. So contribution per unit comes out to be 1000 minus 600. So 400 is the contribution per unit, 400. So this gives you how much? 1250. So you have to produce 1250 units in order to break even. The first question was, what is the minimum level of production for Anil to decide positively in favor of this business? So at minimum, this means at minimum, at minimum the production, production of 1251 units, because at 50 units it's no profit, no loss. Why would you start a business for no profit, no loss? So mathematically there has to be at least, you know, a positive number for you to decide. So 1251 units would mean there is some, you know, small amount of profit. However, would you decide to start the business? Will you take up opportunity at 1251? Possibly not, but this is the minimum that you would expect, and then you negotiate at the top of it. So this is the answer to first question. The second is, when will he break even? So what is the time when you can expect him to break even? So if it is about time, then we have to look in terms of months or years. The production capacity is 500 units a year. The capacity is 500 units per year. Now, in order to break even, you have to produce 1251 units, which means that you will have to, you know, go on for more than 1 year. So how many more is what we're going to figure out now. So if you look at a timeline, this is year 1, year 2, so 500, 500, and year 3, 500. And if you look at cumulative numbers, then you will have 500 done in the first year. You will have 1000 done in the second year and 1500 done at the end of third year. So somewhere in between here, you will clock 1251 units, and that is when you will start making profit. So clearly it is minimum 2 years, but less than 3 years. If you want to figure out exactly how much time, then you just, you know, do the numbers here, which come out to be 2 point something, of course. So this is 2.5 years. So approximately 2 years and 6 months is the time that Anil would need to break even, to reach at this break even level, because the production capacity is limited. The third question is, what is the profit potential vis-a-vis production capacity? So production capacity is 500 units. Now profit potential is actually something very subjective, but you know, a lot of subjectivities go into decision making as well. Now I want to take the quantity of break-even point, and I want to take quantity at the maximum capacity, and I want to say at what percentage capacity. So 1250 is my break-even capacity, break-even level, and the total capacity is 500 per year. So 500 per year, meaning how long can you go on? That's also another question. So let's add another piece of small information here. Let's say this contract period. The contract period was 5 years. You have this deal for 5 years. So if it is for 5 years, then you can produce 500 units every year. So that is 2500 maximum unit that you have. So this is capacity over 5 years. This is the total sales that business would offer, this opportunity will offer to you. So if this is the total capacity, total profit potential, then you are operating at 50%. So the remaining 50% units after 2.5 years, remaining 2.5 years, you will be in green, which means you will be making profit. So is this a good profit potential or bad profit potential? You could compare it with what else would you do if you don't take up this opportunity. So again, that makes it more subjective. But as I said, subjectivity is also involved in such decisions. But how do you use the capacity, the quantity of break-even in this analysis is what I wanted to convey to you in this tutorial. All right, I'll see you in the next video.